So my grind for Atomic Camo keeps on rolling, even though right now as of recording and publishing this video, Atomic is actually not possible due to a few weapons, one universally still not tracking. The Panzerfaust 3 streak in one game camo challenge isn't tracking at all, and for those attempting the long shots, it tracks, but they have to be direct impacts for them to count as of right now. And depending on individuals, some weapons like the STG may still not be tracking multi-kills and perhaps kills or headshots overall, depending on if you rank that weapon up in Warzone before launch or not, and a couple of others. But while Atomic is still not entirely possible, my current goal is to get caught up and get as close to completion before they fix everything entirely and make it possible. In doing so, I realized, however, that we never talked about how to get Diamond in the easiest and most efficient ways as possible. So today, I want to run down some tips that I've found helpful across my camo grind so far and share them with you so that hopefully it can help you out and make your grind a little easier. We're going to be talking about weapons and categories in specific a bit, so hopefully covering the basis for all types of weaponry you may encounter. But as we go along, let me know your thoughts down below. How's your grind going this year? Are you going for gold, diamond, or atomic camo? And which of them is your favorite? Drop your thoughts down below, but if you enjoyed the video, do me a favor, drop a like on the video. If it helps you out in any way, shape, or form, you find it at all insightful, and maybe share it with a friend who may be struggling on their grind. I'd love to be able to help out as many as possible. And if you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button so you don't miss a single thing running all things Vanguard, anything COD related for more guides, tutorials like this, and also up-to-date news and information. We're rounding into 2020 here on that road to 500,000 subscribers, and with nearly 70% of viewers not subscribed, if you'd like to stay up to date with everything, I'd love to have you in the community. That said, let's jump into it. First notable bits of information here, kind of starting as a baseline. The challenges themselves across the board aren't necessarily hard, but mostly just tedious and sometimes just downright annoying. The truly biggest hurdle I think here in terms of camo grinding is ranking up every weapon fully to unlock each of the challenges. Primaries can go all the way up to level 70, secondaries can go up to level 60. I'm in the process of compiling a best ways to rank up your weapons now that should be, hopefully, fingers crossed, be up in the next couple of days here, since we've seen so many adjustments to XP rates across Vanguard and now Warzone with the integration, it's kind of been moving targets. But anyways, naturally the best times to take advantage of weapon leveling is during double weapon XP events, or if you have double weapon XP tokens. Luckily, as of when this is published, we're in the middle of perhaps the longest double weapon XP event that we've had on the year so far, so with it being the holiday season and hopefully more time to relax and do whatever you want, hopefully you can make some solid progression. Secondly, when entering into the camo grind, take note that getting diamond only requires the base number of weapons in each category to be completed. So as the year goes on, we will get more weapons added into each category, but you only need the base number of what launched. So this tip comes in handy immediately because there's a workaround for some people that may not be able to get diamond assault rifles like I couldn't. And also the melee grinds are already a little bit easier, but we can touch on that in a little bit. But just know that, for example, the game launched with 7 assault rifles. Diamond only requires 7 assault rifles to be completed with gold camo, so that means that right now, with 8 assault rifles in the game, you only have to complete 7 of them. For example, if my STG was tracking, I could have skipped the Itra burst because the hipfire and quickscoping challenges, they sucked, so I could have saved myself the pain, but alas, I had to do them in place of my STG since I couldn't get that gold. Thirdly, before we jump into specific tips, don't care about your KD or stats, especially when you get more and more into the grind for the less favorable weapons. Letting go of that sort of need to be the best in the lobby saves your sanity greatly. And listen, I'm the same way. I always want to be doing the best, and oftentimes with regular weapons, my 14 years of COD experience shows that off at the top of the leaderboard of most matches. But that ego, letting go of it and realizing I'm not going to be going double, triple positive with a launcher or an SMG built for long shots, it just makes it more bearable, whereas I'd be punching the air if I felt that I needed to be finishing first in everything still. Just let that go. You're going to die on this grind a lot, but once it's done, you can have that South Park moment of, well, what do we do now? What do you mean? We can finally play the game. And you'll have that mastery camo to show for it. Now, overall, in terms of tips, predominantly you'll have your challenges of eliminations, headshots, multi-kills, bloodthirsties, long-range kills, close-range kills as your standards. Everything after that is more so classification for weaponry and even weapon-specific. The Wildcat challenges and beyond, that's what we'll go into a little bit more detail. For eliminations, though, just play the game. These will come naturally and oftentimes will be completed like about halfway through your weapon grind and attempt to complete the rest of the camo challenges. Headshots, aim higher, always try to keep your centering and crosshairs at chest to head height in game so you always can be aiming for those headshots, naturally giving you better TTK, obviously, but this also may take a little bit of practice and time to get used to, but it does help out greatly. And again, you can knock out these headshots before you even get to maybe even the level 50 and 60 challenges. challenges overall, so you're still hitting it and completing it in stride. Multi-kills, this is anything that's considered to be a double kill or higher, so play modes like Shipmas currently if you can live with the absurd incendiary grenade spam. Modes that prioritize smaller, higher-paced matches like Shipment and Doss House, those are always great options. You'll get these in honestly no time at all, depending on what game mode you play, what map you play on, and if you have a squad with you. You might even be able to knock these out in 1 to 2 matches. Bloodthirsties, these are 5 kill streaks with the guns, but a little helpful pointer which we'll mention again later on in the video, especially for guns like snipers, which may be a bit more tedious and annoying to play with to string together those 5 kills. As of recording this, to my knowledge, the challenge tracks the Bloodthirsty metal counting kill, so that means that in theory, for say snipers, you can get 4 kills with literally any other weapon, STG, bar, MP40, whatever, and swap then to your sniper, get that 5th kill, and it'll count as your Bloodthirsty. So that's something you can take into consideration. Long range kills, this varies depending on the weapon classification. To my knowledge, this means that rifles need long shots of 38 plus meters, SMGs are 30 meters and beyond, shotguns 12 meters, LMGs 38 meters, marksman rifles 38 meters, sniper rifles 52 meters, so pretty long on that one, handguns 20 meters, and launchers 20 meters. So it really depends. The trickier ones to me were the SMGs, because oftentimes lower bullet caliber equals less damage, and the best ways to complete these quickly were in hardcore, so you'd have things like a lot of visual kick in terms of recoil oftentimes and needing to hit 2 kills, so it just was kind of a pain. I'd recommend just sacrificing the KD and playing hardcore DOS House when the playlist is available. Mid-map end-to-end is long shot material, and you can often just jump in and spray players down. I'd highly recommend also running piercing vision during this grind, so you can end up seeing the outlines of enemies amidst the spam of explosives and inevitable dust clouds or smoke cutting off the vision through mid-map. For other things like rifles, LMGs, marksmans, big map blitz is great while it's around. Most encounters you'll find in that is long shot eligible. Honestly, one of my favorite maps for this was one of my least favorite maps going into it, of Desert Siege. I'd suggest trying to hold down the train car side of the map. I want to say it's the C flag domination side, where you can end up going looking over on top of the train car into the mid map courtyard outside of their A spawn. And it doesn't seem that far, but each kill is actually long shot material. Players will just run through mid map at that point. Oppositely, the train crash side on A side, that ends up having a barrel that you can mount that overlooks an exit point from C flag, so that's easy to get long shots in as well. A lot of people like the dunes side of that map, but for me, especially in hardcore, it was harder to spot and aim in on players before I got killed with how many minuscule head glitches there were on either side, so it's kind of like if you're posted up, you have the advantage here in a lot of those gunfights, so re-entering it is kind of tough. Other maps like Hotel Royal, that mid-map long hallway is great for that as well, so there's a lot of different places that can help out in that regard. Close range kills, these again come in time. Your smaller map modes will definitely let you complete this passively, so just play those where applicable. But like we said, the Wildcat categories and up is where it becomes per weapon classification and per weapon in particular. So let's start out with the assault rifles. Assault rifles, the Wildcat challenge is to get 250 kills with 10 attachments. So that's easy as pie, just do that passively. Just make sure you have all your attachments added as possible. You'll see a handful of long shot challenges again, which is kind of evil, but not as evil as the Bren having 3 sets of long shot challenges, all totaling 300 required, but those you'll just kind of have to suffer through, unfortunately. Back to big map blitz or surfing for Demyansk or something like that. The bar has bullet penetration kills, these using the BMG rounds, so it should make it a little bit easier, but I'd run piercing vision. One of my favorite spots to farm these is the C flag room right before Oval, just outside of spawn in DOS House, where you can look into the B flag, and with piercing vision equipped, you can get that painting of where an enemy is, and it's just a matter of point and click at that point. Some assault rifles have kills while moving. Just make sure that you're walking while ADS, it should count here. That's an easier one, but something you gotta be a little bit more conscious of. Hipfire kills with the AS-44 weren't too bad, just build it as required for the challenge and jump into shipment. You'll get it done in like 2 to 3 domination games, but again, expect to die a lot. Kills without taking damage from an enemy, this is one you'll see across rifles, but also other classifications as well. So just note that this is only something that applies to those that you're shooting at. If you get shot from another enemy, a third party, you're totally fine. It still counts for you. It's just only taking into account that one-on-one gunfight, so that's something that you should be able to breeze through these as well. Now, the Itra Burst is the only other one that in the rifle category really was kind of a pain. It has 2 challenges that are just straight up evil. Firstly, the kills after recently aiming down sights. This one seems to be finicky in terms of its tracking, what's classified as recently after aiming down sights. The only surefire way that I found was that after I quickly ADS'd, I hit a one burst headshot, which with the build they require for this challenge is the only way you'll get a one burst because there's no vital in the mix. But just make sure that you ADS and fire as fast as you can and you'll make some progress on it. Secondly, the hip fire kills. This one's best done in hardcore shipment because you only have a 12 round mag, so 3 bursts and you have to hip fire it. It is a living hell, so I'm not gonna lie to you, it's one of my least favorite challenges I think I've ever done. Just buckle up, bite the bullet, it's probably gonna be pain, but you can get it done within 3 to 4 domination matches in shipment. On a lighter note though, SMGs, hip fire kills are the Wildcat challenge specific set for this as well. This one relatively easy, shipment or DOS house, you'll have to consciously go for these, yes, but they'll be done in a few games of domination. You'll likely see your things like long shots pop up again. These can be a pain. I'd, if at all possible, recommend that mid-map DOS house grind, but other things like that, playing hardcore domination, finding the lanes on maps like Desert Siege, Hotel Royals, mid-map hallways, phenomenal. End-to-end as a long shot, even if you mount up on those giant pillars for extra recoil control and stability, you're totally fine. These, not gonna lie, pain in the ass, tedious as ever, but relieving when you're done with them. Kills while crouched or prone, this again, just conscious effort on this one, not terrible, just tedious more so than anything else. Where there are those double ups on long shots, sometimes SMGs will have 2 long shot challenges. Try and save those so that you can knock out both long shot challenges at once. 2 birds, 1 stone type of deal. It'll save the stress in the long run, that's for sure. Most of my long shots on SMGs were conscious efforts, so when I got around to, okay, I need to do long shots, at the most, I'd have like 10 long shots done already passively on each of my SMGs. So saving them shouldn't be too much an issue, but try and knock out long shots in tandem if you can for those weapon specific ones where there's 2 long shots like the Type 100 has. Shotguns, honestly, all of these can be confined within DOS house or shipment. I don't remember a lot of these really being anything more than tedious. LMGs, the base Wildcat challenge is bullet penetration kills. For this, I'd highly recommend piercing vision. Again, coming back to that trick of overlooking DOS house B flag, but at the same time, you can do this as you progress with piercing vision equipped and that ability to do it naturally while going for other camo challenges on a lot of other maps. There's a lot of wall bangable spots. Hipfire as cliche an answer. Shipment again, just stick through the pain perhaps in hardcore and grind it out. The Bren's the only one that I think is honestly kind of annoying because you have 3 separate challenges of long shots, totaling 300 altogether. This was like the one gun that I actually finished my 100 long shot challenges before I even got to the second long shot challenge. But if you can, make sure you double up if at all possible to save yourself that hassle, otherwise you're just going to have to grin and bear it. Marksman and sniper rifles, close range kills are kind of those ones that are tedious, and these are more so where you gotta kind of play aggressive or more aggressive than the laid back sniper style, but it's something that put on an iron sight, a lower magnification scope, play for kills. Close range has been greatly modified since launch, so it's pretty generous now and you'll kind of come across these naturally. Bloodthirsties, again, these were just tedious. I'd highly recommend doing that swap method, 4 kills of any other weapon and then switch to your sniper rifle for that 5th and get credit for it. Pistols, that's one where just one word with this, hardcore. I did the majority of camo challenges for pistols in hardcore. For what it's worth, one shot most of the time, so there's that, and it helps out greatly. The Wildcat challenge for this is kills shortly after swapping to your secondary, and again, frankly, I just continuously would YY because it's just more so an annoying thing in smaller maps on hardcore. I think what I did is have a riot shield on my back and then I'd YY and get those done. Long shots, DOS house, or even shipment works for these truthfully. End to end on shipment is pretty easy and it's in long shot territory, so that's something that helps out greatly. You'll get these done with relative ease if you're going for them. Kills without taking damage in hardcore, pretty easy. It's basically just every kill you get and accumulate goes towards that because most of the time what you go up against will be one shot material. Launchers, we put out a full guide here on the launchers themselves, so without being too repetitive, firstly, I'd say get these done passively. Put on a launcher on every class, do it while you progress other weapons. If you hear an enemy UAV or streaks called in, swap in and take them out. Run Engineer, though, helps infinitely in spotting streaks. The lead time for things like your Panzer Shrek and your Bazooka isn't all that much, especially with things like the recons. They'll slow down when they reach that angled approach. They come in at much faster speeds when coming into the map. Once they're there, they slow down greatly. 3 streaks in one game for the Bazooka and the Panzer Shrek, not the Panzer Faust, all work correctly though. So things like your recons, counter recons, and even things like your individual dogs, whether guard dogs or dogs from the pack, you can take out 3 of those and it counts. Your flame knots, your war machines, those all count as well. Long shots for launchers, it's 20 meters, so end-to-end on DOS house or even shipment. Hardcore is great for these, so things like your Mark 11 works just fine. The Panzerfaust, though, right now, is bugged where it has to be direct impact. The Mark 11's double and triple kills, you'll get these with relative ease in hardcore shipment or DOS house when available, but if you want to get it done in, say, core, you can do the swap method, get two kills quickly with a regular gun, swap and get your third kill, and that triple kill will count on your Mark 11. I want to say that normally you'll have enough time to swap without any attachments that modify that swap speed and get that launcher off, and it'll count for that triple kill, but if you hit marker or miss, it is something that that counter will then reset. Melees, now this is the only other really sort of hack here in terms of this. Now that we have the katana and the sawtooth, do one of those in place of the shield. You only need two melees, so you can do two melee actual weapons instead of the riot shield. Nothing against those who already completed it, and honestly more power to you, but you'll save yourself a bit of sanity by not having to play hardcore to complete the challenges required, since the shield is a two hit in core and other melees are one. So you only need to do two for diamond melees. Give that a go. Totally forego the combat shield if you can. But anyways, that is how you get diamond on the specific classifications of weaponry and in as efficiently and easiest of ways as possible. So that said, that's where we're gonna wrap it up. I'd love to hear your thoughts and feedback down below. Any of these tips help you out in any way, shape, or form? Have you found this insightful? You gonna share it with a friend? Whatever the case, drop your thoughts down below. But if you enjoyed the video, do me a favor, drop a like on the video. And of course, if you are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a single thing running all things Vanguard, all things Warzone, anything COD related. We got you covered here on the channel. So if you're interested, hit the subscribe button. But that said, thanks so much for watching. My name is Espresso. I'll see you guys later. Take care and peace.